What up and welcome back, Will Maker. Today, I'm going to go over my top features, shortcuts when I'm working in FL Studio. A lot of the features and shortcuts I'm going to go over are either for beginners or people switching DAWs and wondering, how do you do those basic commands in FL? So the first thing I'm going to go over is how to copy and paste the pattern. Now, the thing to pay attention to is you're going to pay attention to the magnet. Make sure that you're going to be selecting down here. This is actually going to be snapping the cursor to the actual grid. This basically just shows you the grid. You can actually go in between the bars, so you're not going to get an accurate length if you select up here. So make sure that you select down here. Now, what you're going to do is you can double click and you can highlight this region. And once you have that selected, then you can do Command B. That's going to duplicate your pattern at the exact length. Now, you can also highlight your region right here. What you can also do if you were going to copy this entire pattern, you can do Command A, and then you can copy it this way with Command B. But in this case, we're just doing a little four-bar loop, so that's going to be our accurate measure. If you want to copy the entire pattern, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to come over here to the playlist. And what you're going to want to do is you're going to copy the pattern over. You're going to copy the next pattern so that way you can duplicate it. So now you have 8 bars versus 4. And the key is you're going to want to make sure and you're going to want to highlight this whole thing. So you can either hold Command and drag. You can come up here and you can grab the Select tool. Just make sure that this entire thing is selected. Once you do that, go ahead and hit Command G. Once you hit Command G, now if you come over to the channel rack, you'll notice that the channel rack now is completely duplicated with now 8 bars. So if you come now into the piano roll, you'll notice that you have an extra bar. So that's another thing that you can also do to duplicate your entire pattern. Now, another feature which you can also do, which is a quick command, is you can also quantize, and that's going to help you line things up. So the shortcut for that is going to be Option Q. This is going to be up your quantizer. Now, in order to add swing, which I feel is really important on especially drums, you can come over here and you're going to have a lot of different options that you can go ahead and select. This is where you can mess with the options on the swing there. Now, another thing as well, if you wanted to delete an entire measure, so say for instance you don't want to have this, you can select the measure that you don't want, and all those notes on a PC I believe you can just hit delete, but on a Mac what we have to do is we have to hit FN and then delete, and that's going to delete the measures here for us. Another feature as well that I like to use, you can mute certain things just to hear how they sound. So instead of deleting and adding back, you can just mute it so that way it stays in place. So what you can do is you can come up here to the mute tool. So to find what the shortcuts here for these are, on a PC, I believe all you have to do is you see right here, it's going to show you right there what the shortcut is. So in this case, the pencil tool is going to be a P. The mute tool is going to go ahead and be a T. On a Mac, it doesn't work that way. So what you want to do is you want to hit Control Shift, and then if you hit T, it's going to switch the tool to the mute tool. And now at this point, you can just click. And then a quick shortcut, if you wanted to go ahead and just delete a measure on a Mac, you can just hit Control and left click, and then that'll go ahead and delete the measure. To get the roll on a hi-hat, what you can do is you can use the chopper tool. So if you want your hi-hats to sound like, what you basically do to bring up the chopper tool here, Option U will bring up the chopper tool, and here's where you can select the strength of it. So if you want it to really give you that roll. Okay, so the next thing is going to be strum. So you can do Option S, and Option S will go ahead and bring up the bring up the strum tool, and then you can go ahead and you can select the strength that you want to go ahead and have your piano or guitar make a more realistic type of strum versus having it so computerized. So it gives it a lot more humanized feel. And the next thing is going to be if you wanted to check the key of a sample. So what you come down here and you do is you select your sample. And what you'll do is you'll go ahead and right click down here on the wave on a Mac. It's going to be holding control and clicking. And you're going to open the audio editor, which is Edison. And once you're in your wave, you right click again. And you come down to regions, and then you detect your pitch region. And then at that point, it's going to tell you what key it's in. So as you can tell, the main root of this is going to be in C, and then it tails off and it goes into G. And you can actually just drag this onto the piano roll if you want to go ahead and just keep that one as is. And so any manipulation that you do, if you want that on its own little track, you can just do that by dragging this over there. And next on the list is going to be one of the new features with FL21. So this is pretty big, especially for mixing. So what you want to mainly do, especially when you got your vocals or whatnot, you want to make sure that you clip gain and got your levels right. So FL Studio finally has a clip gain feature on the actual wave, so you can go ahead and you can get this at the desired level that you're looking for. The other thing that this also does now as well, you can also do fades as well, nice and simple. So that's another nice feature too, to eliminate any of the pops at the end of a sample or, you know, whatnot. And then another useful feature and get it more organized to your liking. So if you want, for instance, all your drums together, you come over here and you hold shift on the track that you want to move. And then you go ahead and you can just scroll with your mouse. And then you can go ahead and drag that closer to the track that you want to go ahead and want it to sit next to. Okay, and then lastly, one of the final things that FL has released with FL21 is you can now change themes. So if you notice, the background to the FL looks a little bit different, and that's because you can go ahead now and you can choose a bunch of different themes to your liking here, and you can change the colors and whatnot. So it's another pretty cool feature that FL's offered, you know, with the lifetime updates and whatnot. So those are my top feature shortcuts here. So if you like what you see, go ahead and like and subscribe. Other than that, peace out and thanks for watching.